Welcome back, everyone. So yes, you can continue. I think Sanjay Belulkar sir was sharing something, right?
Yeah, just trying to highlight that. Just to add to Yash's suggestion here. Depending on the data volume, you need to have a whole system been set up. Some of these tools are just the front face of what you get to see, like Tableau or Power BI. And some of them can do a little bit of data processing. So just to add to what Yash is highlighting.
Okay.
Yeah, over to you, Yash.
Thank you.
Yeah, Ravindra sir has a question. Yes, please, sir.
Yeah. This is Ravindra Deshpande. I'm an architect and a valuer. Okay. Now, my data, whatever question that I'm asking is related to real estate. All of us get our documents registered at sub-register offices. There is a lot of data that is there on the IGR Maharashtra website. It is about leave license agreements or rent agreements or even sale purchase agreements. Typically what happens, you know, is the ready reckoner rates that are there for, see, government publishes the ready reckoners. Ready reckoners give the rates of properties in particular areas all over Maharashtra. So all the states, they publish these kind of ready reckoners. But typically there is a time lag between the market rate and the ready reckoner rate. So there are times when the market could be higher and the ready reckoner rate could be lower. And there would be times, you know, as the last 3-4 years, if you've seen, the ready reckoner rates could be higher and the market rate actually could be lower. Now, in such a case, what happens is there is always a problem that the industry faces, the real estate industry faces, because the premium that are charged by the municipal authorities are based on those ready reckoner rates. So if the time lag between the two can be, you know, minimized and the ready reckoners are able to reflect the actual market rate, in that case, it would be a reprieve for the real estate industry also, and it would also help the government in actually getting a proper revenue that they should be collecting. Because in current scenario, what is happening is the ready reckoner rates are higher. So the payments to the government, whether it is premium to be paid to corporation for getting permission, or whether it is stamp duty to be paid, places, you know, and the income tax department and the income tax department. This is where, you know, it comes into play. So if you can come up with some solution for this kind of an issue, maybe you could take it up as a business assignment also, because there are quite a few Ajinkyans who are working in these departments.
Yes, so based on the inputs which you have given, so what I am thinking loud right now is we can come up with a dynamic solution for this. So as you are speaking, the data is coming up dynamically from multiple sources into a system, and you want something to be happening very quickly, right? So we can design a formula for this, and based on the ups and downs, we can trigger something.
Okay, we can, you know, interact further offline also. So I can give you the inputs.
Yes.
From there you can take it forward.
Yeah, sure. Sure.
Yes.
So
yes, I have a question. Yes, Yogesh here.
Yes, yes.
Yeah, the parallel technology running is machine learning. How they are mutually convenient for
audio each other. Mute
yeah. Hello.
Hello.
Yes.
Yeah. Question is, machine learning also is equally upcoming area. So how these two functions are interrelated that way?
Yes. Machine learning is interrelated in many ways. So as the inputs given by Ravindra sir, I would recommend that you should integrate your problem statement with the machine learning as well, because there are certain scenarios which a computer can't understand on a dynamic thing. So Nitin Bausa sir is also here, so he's more expert in machine learning than me. So
I can probably answer that question for you, Yash. Yeah, so I can probably answer that question, Yash.
Yes,
so AI and ML will be a bigger gamut, and data analytics is a subset of AI ML. So just to answer your question, Yogesh, your analysis, your data will feed into machines for machines to predict it. That's how it works. Whereas analytics mainly, like, you know, you produce the data and you've given it to someone to make a decision. So you're asking human to take a decision. Whereas machine in future will take this data and make a decision. That's the difference between two.
Okay.
You got it? It's a subset of AIML.
Yeah, got it.
Yeah, we have a question from Dr. Saroj. Yes, doctor. Oh, what happened? She was raising her hand. Okay. Anyways, we can take other question. Yeah.
Yes.
Any more questions, please?
Yes, one more question. Yes, I have one more question. So obviously, when you say people, those who are yet to choose their careers, they can start looking at this aspect. So let's say still they are finishing their final examinations or so, or maybe final exams of graduation of 3 years or 4 years. Is there anything that they should start reading or start looking at or doing some projects which can help them to cultivate the more interest in this kind of subjects and maybe do some case studies?
Yeah, sure. So when we talk about this particular field, so when we talk about data science, it is basically a large field. So what I would suggest is don't directly just go to use cases. Just try to see the problems and situations around you and try to pen and paper a solution of it. And after that, try learning the languages, as I said, the Python, R, and the visualization tools like Tableau and Power BI and all that. So when a person has a particular problem statement in mind and when he starts learning that thing, so he progressively starts to connect the both two things. Okay. So in that way, he can interactively learn by his own. And speaking of the platforms which are available online, so YouTube is one of the best platform, I would say, because there you can, there are many things are, many videos are there, which can help you interactively in learning all these things. And many websites are there dedicated to this. So some of which are DataCamp and many more are there, like Analytics Vaidya and all. So I would say to make a plan out of it and start following that plan.
Okay.
Hello.
I think Kamal Kishore Uke does have a question. Yeah.
Yes, I want to ask you which type of project you have worked in DRDO, whether it was a aerial remotely operated vehicle or underwater. I am working in CSIR and I have worked in both type of projects, okay, especially underwater robotics with this DRDO NSTL lab Visakhapatnam, but I am from mechanical side, of course. Okay,
I am also from mechanical side, sir.
So how you have utilized this data analysis for analyzing the data?
Let me clarify you this thing, that when I was in college, I took this a competitive project. So at that time I was pursuing my mechanical engineering, but right now I am working as a data scientist. So there is no connection in between the two, but sometimes I try to relate both of this. And as you told that you wanted to know that what my project was. So we designed a vehicle, we called it MURB, which is military unmanned robotic platform. So there were 3 to 4 scenarios on which we have to give some ideas or build a project. So our idea was based on saving lives of the soldiers who are trapped in the cross-country fire situation. So many a times what happens that a soldier is injured and his squadron man goes to him for the help, but what usually happens is he also gets shot. So to minimize the casualties, we made a robot that will go to the injured person, will lift that injured person, keep it in a bag or a stretcher, and all these components are in the robot only, and it will bring back the injured soldier to the medical team.
So it will be something like humanoid robot?
Not a humanoid robot. So the model which we made it was kind of a car only. You can visualize it as a tank. That's what I will say.
Okay.
A tank which is huge enough to carry a person.
Okay. Another question which I wanted to ask you is, many mathematical models failed to predict exactly how this corona infection will happen in India. So where was the mistake?
Okay, so I will say that when we make a model in the analytics and all that, we have the data of past. So we have to inject that data of past. And we usually make two data sets, the trained data set and the test data set. So what happens is a huge part of the data is converted into the trained data set, which will train the model on how to react, means how to behave in a certain situation. And the test data set is kind of when the model understands the behavior, we give the test data to model and we see how accurate the model is behaving. So and also there are many parameters. So what I think is when the model was being created, some parameters were misguided and some parameters were left off. So that's what I think. The prediction is not proper.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Any more questions, please?
I am getting some questions in chat.
Okay, please answer those then. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yes, someone is asking that is there an Ajinkyan group on LinkedIn where we can continue this? Ganesh, there is asking that.
Yes. Yes, you know, I think we're going to very soon run out of time, and every 40 minutes, I know Shashikant and Yogesh are kind of extending the call. But I just wanted to say that, I mean, such discussions are usually better done on professional platforms rather than on a WhatsApp chat. And again, there's a limit on WhatsApp because, you know, you only have 255 members, and these are usually organized by the batch groups or city groups, etc. Right. So one of the ideas and thoughts is we have a group on LinkedIn. Everyone who's interested can join the group. And on LinkedIn, there is a facility to have different conversations on different subjects. So, you know, a great presentation, Yash. As you probably know, we also have a number of, you know, renowned data analytics experts within the Ajinkyan community, and Sanjay Belulkar, who used to live in Australia and now lives in the US. He's a world-renowned expert on this. You know, I can't say enough about him. So similarly, on various different subjects, you know, we have lots of kind of expertise within our Ajinkyan fraternity. And one way of trying to harness it and kind of keep that knowledge together and let people talk to each other outside the framework of the Zoom calls, because sometimes you don't have a question right now on the Zoom call on any subject, you know, Shashikant, right, whether it's data analytics or it was to do with, you know, registering your house and avoiding pitfalls in the house buying process, etc., from some days ago, whatever the subject is. So sometimes you get a question afterwards. Absolutely. So not every time you have the contact of the person who gave the presentation. So if you have LinkedIn, and I use LinkedIn very frequently, That's one avenue. So the group is already set up. I think there's more than 100 members. I don't think there is any limit on LinkedIn group membership. We can have as many as we want. So send me a request. I will add you. For people whose names I recognize, you know, I'll add you directly. But some of the junior Ajinkians, if I don't recognize your name, just as a security check, send me your school number and your house and perhaps the name of your batch coordinator. And I have a list of the batch coordinators, so I know whether it's a legitimate Ajinkian, bona fide Ajinkian or not.
Right.
So that's all I wanted to say. But Yash, you know, you're a very young person, you know, and it's nice to have, you know, the son of an Ajinkian, you know, and Saraf sir's grandson do a presentation. So very well done to you, and keep it up, you know. And it's only by making these presentations and talking to people that you kind of improve your career and grow your confidence. So very well done.
Yeah, absolutely. And Ganesh sir, like say, the purpose of conducting such kind of session was to make Ajinkians aware about the expert in Ajinkian fraternity, as well as like we are going to share the details. Like say it could be email ID, phone numbers, everything by the end of like the lockdown. We are going to share each and everything with all the Ajinkian members, so that like the people should get connected with the respective experts.
Correct.
Because we have so many experts in our, but then we are unable to utilize their expertise.
Exactly. Exactly.
Right. So thank you, Yash. And let's try to connect like the offline whenever like somebody does have any questions or they need your assistance, right?
Just one announcement.
Yeah.
One announcement, Shashikant. The next session is on Wednesday, 27th of May. Will be Balaji Birazar. I will be sharing the details by day after tomorrow or so. Stay tuned for that. Okay.
Sure.
All right. Thank you, guys.
Thanks a lot. Thanks all, Ajinkya.
Thank you, Yash.
Thank you very much, sir.
Okay.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Bye-bye. Bye-bye.